Charming cabin, my ass. Oh. Hey, little dude. Nope, 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 nope.
Thank you.
Here we go. Hey, Mom. And Dad, it's me, Brittany. Obviously, you know what I fucking look like. Okay. Hey, Mom. It's Brittany. You're probably wondering why you haven't heard from me in a while. You too, Dad. Hey, Mom. I'm sorry I haven't been home in a while. And I'm also sorry that I'm not gonna be home ever again. So, bye.
You're awake.
You okay? You hit your head outside, so I brought you in here.
Who are you?
I'm Jack.
Okay.
Okay. I guess you were cleaning the cabin, and you must have fallen off the steps.
No. I was outside, and I was on the phone. No, dude, I booked this cabin for the weekend.
What? No.
Yeah.
I booked this cabin for the weekend.
Me too.
No. My confirmation number?
All right, wait. Come on. Here. Look. Confirmation number YUT7754, Brittany Reed.
This must be a joke, right?
No, this is not a joke, all right? You're trespassing and you need to leave.
No, I made my reservation a long time ago, so it's mine, please.
I'm not leaving, all right? I am going to call the owner because this is absolutely absurd. Of course there's no reception.
I'll try.
Like you're gonna get reception with that thing.
Thomas?
Yeah.
Hi, this is Jack speaking.
Who?
Jack, I rented your cabin for the weekend.
Oh, the French guy.
Yeah.
Right.
Listen, there's another person here. It's a young girl, and she says she rented the cabin as well, but that can be, right?
Yeah, that could be.
What do you mean?
Must have double booked a cabin, right?
What? Okay, hold on. Hold on, please. Thomas, can you repeat what you just said?
I said it must have double-booked the cabin, all right? What do you want me to do, jump in my truck and drive up there? I don't think so. Figure it out. Okay?
So you double-booked the cabin?
Yeah, pal. I double-booked the cabin. Big fucking deal.
What now?
Here, I'm gonna give you $500 so you can leave now.
I'm not leaving.
Please.
No, I have been planning this for weeks and I am staying here, okay?
Okay, $750?
Dude, did you not hear me? I'm not leaving, okay? Just get your money back from that guy and book somewhere
else. I'm not leaving, so you make your choice. Either you leave now or I'll make you leave, all right?
I think that we can find a way to figure this one out,
please,
okay?
Please, come on.
Putain! Plus de connasse américaine! You're out of your mind! Please give me my bags. My stuff. Come on. If I was a real threat to you, you'd have no chance. You just gave me my bags. Didn't even check them. For all you know, I have a gun. This is how you thank me? I took care of you. I could have left you here.
Ouais, je pense qu'il faut qu'on change de lieu de rendez-vous. Non, il n'y a aucun problème. C'est juste que... Il y a quelqu'un ici. Une jeune fille, elle a booké la cabine en même temps. Non, elle ne présente aucun danger. J'ai tout checké. C'est... Ok. Je m'en occupe.
Hey, can we talk?
the 750 and I'll let you sleep on the hammock.
$500, and I won't press charges for assault.
Fine.
Back down.
Sorry, I haven't been home in a while, and I'm also sorry that I'm not gonna be home ever again, so, bye.
I need to use the bathroom.
Are you still there?
What?
Why this cabin?
I could ask you the same question. I'm a writer. I came here to finish my novel.
How cliché.
It's not cliché if it's true.
First or second?
Does it matter?
Well, you're not a real novelist if you haven't written a single book. So what's it about?
I'm sorry?
Your book?
Oh, yeah, it's a work in progress.
You have no idea.
Do you know the story of Lolita? It's a classical story about a young woman who's having a relationship.
It's disgusting. I've read it.
It's not disgusting. It's about innocence and the loss of it through lust and love. Not disgusting.
Just don't use my real name.
I wasn't going to.
Good.
Huh. Of course.
You know I'm not afraid of you.
Clearly. What are you doing here?
Boyfriend broke up with me.
That is cliche. There will be more boys. Trust me. You should think about more important things like your studies, your career. Boys. All they want is to get into your pants.
All right, that's enough dad advice for one day. I'm good, thank you.
What? I got bored.
How's your head?
It's okay. Took some aspirin.
When I was your age, I was never bored.
No. When a person's choking, if you hit their back like that, you're gonna drive the block deeper instead of expelling it.
You learned that in college?
Wikipedia. So you're French?
Yeah.
Did you grow up in France?
No. Morocco.
But you're French.
Yeah, my dad moved us to Morocco when I was 7. We lived in Agadir, 8 years. Best years of my life. But then we had to move back to Paris. What about you?
Faith, North Carolina.
Faith?
Mm-hmm. Population 987. At least the last time I checked, that's what it was. I don't know. Could be different now. What about you? How many people are in Agadir-na-na-na? Or whatever you called it.
Agadir.
Yeah.
Back then, 400,000. I'm sure it doubled by now. So your boyfriend, why did he leave?
I don't want to talk about it.
I don't really drink.
Why?
I don't want to talk about it.
Okay. So, I mean, what are you really doing here?
I told you, I'm a writer.
You don't look like a writer.
What do they look like?
I don't know. But I feel like you should have, like, a laptop and a notepad or something.
Should go easy on that.
Look.
That's twice now you've given me dad advice. One more time and I take away the hammock. Look, I appreciate the basic male need to be a father figure, but I am a grown woman. I can take care of myself. What?
You remind me of someone.
Jesus, don't say your ex-girlfriend. Be like the worst pickup line I've ever heard. I'm rude. Do you want a ham and cheese sandwich?
No, thank you.
They're really good. You should get in on it.
I don't eat ham.
I'm gonna slaughter this sandwich for you. Completely hamless, just for you. What?
You eat your sandwich like her.
Who?
Sophie.
Who's Sophie?
My daughter.
I like that name. It's pretty. Sophie. How old is she?
She's dead. He didn't run. They found the driver afterwards. He was drunk.
Wow.
They rushed her to the hospital, but it was too late. Yeah, when they called us, there was nothing they could do about it.
I'm so sorry. How old was she?
Twelve. Instead of trying to save her, they just wrote her off. Doctor came. He told me that it would be better to pull the plug now than later. Can you imagine? Ask a man to be the hand that will end his daughter's life. But I had to do it. She was suffering so much.
I mean, to be fair, it did probably save you a lot of money on medical bills. It's one way of looking at it.
That is what it's all about for you? Paying the bills?
No.
Money? You Americans always have this word in your mouth, money. In the meantime, you have all these people dying in your streets. You don't even have respect for them.
Well, first of all, look, I'm sorry for what I said. It was incredibly insensitive. But I'm not the poster child for America. So don't paint all Americans with the same fucking brush, okay? And if you hate America so much, why don't you go back to France? Just a thought.
You know, the rest of the world is laughing at you. But you don't care, of course. I need to rest now.
Well, thanks for the company, I guess. And I'm sorry about what I said about Sophie. I'm sure she was a really awesome girl. What was that? Crow.
Must have fallen from the sky.
That's so creepy.
It's not creepy. It's just nature.
It's dead.
Yeah. It's good luck, you know?
What?
A dead crow?
I don't see how this has anything to do with luck.
You should check Wikipedia.
Oh, shit. You weren't kidding about the gun.
No.
What do you even need a gun for?
Protection.
From what?
You?
We can't just leave him here. I mean, shouldn't we bury him or something? I'm going to. Will you make me a cross?
How do you know the crow was Christian?
Oh, you're right. He was probably a Satanist. You gonna make me a pentagram? That'd be easier? Here. Use this. What, is this against your religion?
What religion?
I don't know. Whatever floats your boat, man.
I'm an atheist.
Okay, me too. I just think the cross is a nice point marker. I got it. Do you think this is it? Like, what happens if one day we fall off like this dead crow onto somebody's roof?
This is not how it works.
You know, for a writer, you're not very metaphorical.
What if when you're dead, you're just dead? There's nothing, nothing at all. You okay?
I'm fine. Sorry.
About what?
For kicking you out of the cabin.
I should head back.
Hey, you know, you don't have to sleep outside. There's plenty of room in the cabin.
I'm okay.
I mean it.
No, it's fine. Really?
No, I... Okay, look, I'm gonna make a formal request. Please come and sleep inside the cabin. Look, it's really creepy out here, and this dead crow falling on the roof is kind of freaking me out. And I don't want to be alone. Okay, how about this? What if I leave in the morning? No fuss. Will you sleep inside?
Good night.
Good night. I didn't come here because my boyfriend broke up with me.
You should sleep now.
I haven't been able to sleep soundly since I was 7.
Insomnia?
Nope.
Your parents, they didn't read bad stories to you, tell you how to count sheep.
My mom's a flight attendant, so I saw her maybe a collective 10 times in a given year. So no sheep or stories. She did take me to Disneyland every year with all of her free miles. That was nice, yeah. That was our happy time. I always looked forward to that.
And your father?
He never wanted a daughter.
Not much of a father.
Nope. He used to hit me. A lot.
I'm sorry to hear that.
I forgave him for the action, just never the why.
What's the why?
I don't think you want to peer down that rabbit hole, Alice.
No. But I think you want me to.
My dad's brother, my uncle, used to touch me. Not in a loving way, a way in which someone with no remorse touches you. Whenever we would go and visit his family, night after night, I would just have to lay there and let it happen to me without making a sound. When I told my dad, he said he didn't tolerate liars. He didn't want a liar living in his house. My mom took me to a shrink. They tried to put me on medication, but that didn't work. It's all my fault.
No. It's not your fault. Your uncle was a sick man, and you were just an innocent child.
I'm not innocent.
Hey.
What?
Why would you do that?
I was comforting you.
No, don't!
Well, I thought this is what you wanted.
No. You need to leave right now. You need to leave right now. You need to leave right now!
Calm down, okay? I'm sorry.
I have to go.
Hey. I don't know what to say. I thought...
No, you didn't think.
I'm sorry.
Do you have any idea what that kind of shit can do to a person like me?
Okay. It was a mistake. It's not your fault.
Will you stop saying that?
Come on, please. Let's go back.
Definitely not what I had in mind when I booked this cabin.
Me neither.
Blacking out. The dead crow. You coming on to me.
I didn't come.
It's fine. It's whatever. Tell me about France, you know? What's it like? I've always dreamed of going to a Parisian cafe and just people watching.
Well, I didn't grow up in Paris. I grew up in the suburbs. La Courneuve. Trust me, it doesn't exactly look like a French postcard. The kind of place where the French government never managed to handle the anger. The frustration. Some of my best friends got really into violence, ideologies. I joined the police.
You're a cop?
Not anymore.
Are you retired?
My family... We didn't feel safe anymore. I made a lot of enemies there, so... People were coming after me.
I just wanted a better life for Sophie, for my wife. So we aimed for the American dream. Starting a new life here.
Somebody come after you? What did they want?
I don't want to talk about it.
That's right. Sorry.
You?
Came here to die.
You're sick?
No. Just tired.
Tired?
The day in and day out struggle to try and find happiness. It's just exhausting. I don't want to suffer anymore.
The pills.
Hurts the least.
You don't really want to die.
We all want to die at some point. Anyone who says they don't is just fooling themselves. Everyone has a time, and my time has come.
Why now? Why here?
Oh, just to get away for the weekend. All the chaos in my head. Go quietly.
And I showed up and ruined everything.
Pretty much.
Well, I suppose I should apologize.
No.
Don't do it.
Getting dangerously close to strike three, Jack.
This is not a dad's advice.
I appreciate it, but I have made up my mind.
If you were going to kill yourself, why did you take my money?
You needed to know who was calling the shots.
You were not.
I guess not anymore, huh? I'm not gonna need this tomorrow.
No.
All right. Maybe I'll just leave it on my body, you know? It's like a prize for someone that finds me.
If they find you.
They'll find me. And if they don't care enough to find me, then, you know, you'll always know where I am.
I suppose.
Will you promise that you'll come visit me from time to time?
Good night, Brittany.
How do you know I haven't taken the pills?
You haven't.
Are you sure about that?
Good night.
La vie est belle. Le destin s'en écarte. Personne ne joue avec les mêmes cartes. Le père soulève le voile. Multiples sont les destins qu'il dévoile. Tant pis. On n'est pas né sous la même étoile.
Morning, sunshine.
How was your party?
What are you doing?
I was actually gonna ask you the same thing, but then kinda answered it for myself when I found all of this.
You had no right to go through my stuff.
Look who's talking.
Please, this is not a toy, all right?
No shit.
You don't know what you're doing. You...
Really?
Come on.
Don't move.
If you connect the wires the right way and a call is made, it will go off.
I was going to tell you.
I don't believe you.
You should go. You should live.
Why do you have this?
You wouldn't understand.
Make me.
I'm not a terrorist.
Who are you?
I told you, I was a cop.
You're gonna have to do better than that.
Okay. My real name is Laurent. I was part of the GIGN, the French counterterrorism unit. Bomb squad. I studied bombs. How to defuse them, how to make them. I knew everything about terrorists. Their cells, who trained where, who came in and out of the country. One day, they found me. They threatened my family. We had to leave France and come here.
Who are they?
During one of our raids, we arrested the son of a radical cleric. His father promised to have my head. But here, they couldn't find me for years. Then, they expanded their cells in the States. And somehow, when the accident with Sophie happened...
If she's even real.
She was. They figured out where I was living. So they showed up one night, proposing a deal. They would take care of the bills, her life support. They would pay for the best doctors. In exchange for a favor.
They're using you, Laurent. You are better than this. You're not a terrorist. You're just a guy that's been taken advantage of and doesn't know a way out. You're not gonna be responsible for killing innocent Americans.
Innocent? No one is innocent. You can't expect starting a war on the other side of this world and just not taking any responsibility for it.
Are you defending them right now? Because what they're doing is pretty untenable. Did they brainwash you or something? Is that what's happening here? Where is this going to be used? Tell me. And if you have to kill me after you tell me, then you know that that is fine with me. Because at least I'm not afraid. Unlike you.
Las Vegas. Times Square. Places where American people go to be happy.
I hate you.
You wanted to know.
How does it feel knowing that your dirty little bomb is going to kill hundreds of innocent people who are just trying to have a happy time in their otherwise shitty lives? Does it make you feel like a real man? Is that it? I'm sure your daughter would be very proud.
Stop it.
You need to get it through your thick French skull, Laurent. No matter how many bombs you make for these whack jobs, she's not coming back.
Don't.
She's gone. She's dead, Laurent, and you are disrespecting her memory. Sophie is not an excuse to build bombs.
Stop it!
You stop it!
Why do you care? My life is meaningless.
If yours is meaningless, then what is mine? It's not too late, Laurent.
Thank you.
For what?
For not. You know. My dad got me a stuffed turtle every year on my birthday. They're such precious creatures surrounded by this hard, rough shell. And they get to choose when they come out and expose themselves. The fucker can have them all back.
You have to go now.
No.
You can't stay.
I still have a reservation, remember?
There's no time for jokes, Brittany. If he finds you here, he's gonna kill you.
I'm not leaving.
Then we both die. I won't do it. I'll find a way out of it.
Wes, mon ami.
Mehdi.
Ça fait un bail.
Ouais.
Tu plaisantais pas quand tu disais que t'allais te mettre au vert. Ça nous a pris du temps pour te retrouver. Même moi, tu m'as laissé sans nouvelles.
C'est bien, t'as tenu ta promesse. Ouais. Mais j'ai changé d'avis. Où est la fille? T'inquiète pas pour ça, elle est partie ce matin tôt. Elle ne sait rien.
Voyons ta petite merveille.
Non.
Tu te souviens à Agadir? La fois où on s'est fait un garage. Tu t'es fait choper pour avoir volé un pneu. Ben, j'ai dit que c'était moi, pour te couvrir. J'ai passé une sale nuit en prison.
Où tu veux en venir?
On change pas comme ça. T'es un des nôtres. Tu l'as toujours été.
C'est toi qui as toujours voulu que je te ressemble. Je suis pas l'un des vôtres.
Tu te rends compte de ce que tu dis? Sans nous, tu croulerais sous les dettes. On t'a sauvé la vie. Et maintenant, c'est ton tour, c'est comme ça. Allez, tends-moi la bombe.
Non.
Donne-moi la bombe.
Tu vas tirer sur ton ami d'enfance?
Est-ce que j'ai le choix? Si je ne ramène pas la bombe, c'est, je suis un homme mort. C'est plus moi qui décide, Laurent. Plus maintenant. S'il te plaît.
Drop the gun!
Breathe, Annie. Stay out of this!
Tu vois que ta petite copine est revenue?
Ok, laisse-la partir, Mehdi. Brittany, please. Drop the gun. Do it. Please.
We have to go.
Well, what about him? We can't just leave him there.
Come.
Well, someone's gonna come. What about your stuff?
Leave it. Come. Take your things.
Give me your phone.